In this lesson two of our GTM for Beginners series, we are going to take a look at how to install Google Tag Manager onto your website. All or more coming up. Hey there, Measure Geeks, Julian here, back with lesson number two of our GTM for Beginners series. If you haven't checked out our first video yet, then go back to that. We have a link down below. And just like in the last lesson, we also have a quiz for this lesson prepared. So head over to measureschool.com/lesson2 and follow along. Maybe you can already answer the first questions while using this video. Let's dive into today's video, where we're going to take a look at how to install Google Tag Manager correctly onto your website. So for that, I'm already on the marketing side of Google Tag Manager, but actually when you use Google Tag Manager, you will access it by going into tagmanager.google.com. And here you are first of all greeted to sign in. You can sign in with any kind of Google account. So this could be your YouTube account, this could be your Gmail account. And if you don't have a Google account, then I trust that you will be able to create one right here. I already have my demo account right here, and we are going to log in and we are inside of Google Tag Manager. If you do this for the first time, you probably greeted with this screen where I actually wanted to get to, because here's where we are going to create our account and our container. Google Tag Manager is made up of accounts and containers. And an account is simply a collection of containers. Now, what are containers? Containers are the snippets that you install onto your website. So a good naming convention would actually be to use your company name. So for example, Demo Inc. And then you can choose the country. This is especially important for privacy reasons. You might want to choose something in Europe if you need to adhere to certain standards here. I'm just going to leave this at United States, and I'm going to share my data anonymously with Google as well. Then I'm going to go ahead and use as a container name my website. So in our case, it would be demoshop.com. This is where I'm going to install this. You don't have to put any URL here, but in order, if you have multiple of these containers, to distinguish them, you will be able to do this with this easy naming convention. And then you choose your target platform. So you can install Google Tag Manager on web platform, iOS, Android, AMP, and server side. But we are in this tutorial going to choose web, because this series is concentrating on web users. But check out our other tutorials where we go into some of the other platforms here as well. So we're going to create this here, and then we have a terms of service agreement. You can read through this and then also accept. Let's click yes here. And we have set up Google Tag Manager, at least the account portion, because now we need to install our snippets. This is very important in order for us to deploy codes through Google Tag Manager. So we are straight away greeted with installing Google Tag Manager onto our website. These are the snippets that you need to install. If you don't see this, or if you want to join us here from a different account, you can always find your container snippets by clicking up into the GTM ID right here, or going into the admin section and then installing your Google Tag Manager option. So here we have these two codes, and they need to be placed onto your website. Now, these are the last, hopefully the last codes that you ever need to install onto your website, because henceforth we can do our tag deployments through Google Tag Manager. Now, obviously this would require a little bit more wider access to your website itself to then place this high up in the head section, and then also underneath the opening body tag. So we have two kind of snippets here that we need to install. To give you an example, I have my demo shop here, which it runs on the CMS WordPress. Now, WordPress is a very well-known and widely used CMS, but you might use something completely different. So the steps will actually differ here. And even within platforms, you have different ways of installing Google Tag Manager onto the platform. So for example, for WordPress, we can put it into the theme files, we could install a plugin, or we could write it into the functions.php file. But once we install it, the outcome should really be the same. So on our website itself, if you go to right-click and view page source here, we can see the HTML that gets downloaded from the server to your browser. And here we should see in the head section our GTM code number one, and then also under the body section, which is further down here, right here, we should also see a second snippet. So how do we install this with our WordPress website here, we have different ways of installing it. I'm going to go through a way that is most applicable to most of the WordPress websites, but you could also put it into your functions PHP. So for that, we need to log into our website backend, and I already have this prepared here. We go to appearances and then theme editor, and I'm going to edit my theme here, but I have actually a child theme installed, so these changes that we are making are not overwritten by any kind of updates that go on in our main theme. And then I'm clicking here on the header PHP file, and here's where we are going to add our snippets. So we have here our opening head tag, and here's where the head starts, and then we also have our body tag somewhere. Where is it? Right here. And we need to place our codes now. So let's go ahead and copy this first code, and we need to put it as high up as possible into the head. So right here would be fine. And then also our second snippet that needs to go beneath the opening body tag. So we're going to put this in here. Let's update our files. And then once it's installed, we should be able to actually inspect our HTML again. So the files were edited. Let's reload this and look into our page source. And now we see here our Google Tag Manager is installed, and at some point also our second snippet right here. All right, so we should have Google Tag Manager installed. How can we actually make sure that it's working? There's a little tool by Google called the Tag Assistant, and you can install it onto your Chrome browser. And here you would now see that Google Tag Manager is installed. When we click on it, we get this in yellow, which is not a good sign because we are still getting a 404 response from our snippet. This is because we haven't published a version yet from Google Tag Manager. So GTM is now installed, but not really getting any data back from Google Tag Manager. And that can be solved by going into our Tag Manager account. Let's go here to our workspace and then submitting a version. This will now be our initialization version. So we're not going to deploy any kind of tracking, but we're going to make sure that our container is ready to be used. And so I'm going to give this a name. Let's call this initialization. So just init, and I'm going to simply publish this onto our website. And we see here our version number one is now being published. We have zero tags and zero triggers and five variables, but no tracking has been deployed right here. So on our page, if we now reload this, we should see inside of our tag assistant that we at least get the blue sign, which is a good sign, sometimes even green, which would let us know that our tag manager is installed correctly. The third step that we can go through is to actually connect this to Google Tag Manager in our preview mode. And this will put our browser into a special mode where we can see what is going on the page relating to Google Tag Manager, but it also gives us the ability to preview any kind of changes that we have made in Google Tag Manager and in our tracking. So I'm going to go here into the preview mode. This will put our browser into a special mode. We need to connect this to the website. So we put an our URL right here, and then click start, and this will connect now to our website. It will actually open it up in a new tab, and you see up here that it's connected because the FAF icon actually changes, and this is now connected to this tag assistant tab as well. And here we already have some little bit of information. We see here we are currently on this demoshop.com site, and if we go and navigate on the page, we should get more information in here. And you need to make sure that Google Tag Manager is installed on any website that can be reached by the user. So click through your website and see if all of the pages actually show up and Google Tag Manager is installed correctly. If not, then you might have a problem with the theme or something is wrong in your plugin settings. Make sure that Google Tag Manager is installed correctly on every website of your webpage in order to make sure that your tracking also gets deployed on every page later on. But this looks pretty promising and pretty good. So we have Google Tag Manager now installed. If you want to exit out of the tag assistant, you can just click this X here, stop debugging this, and we should be back to normal on our page as well. And we are now ready to deploy our first tag with Google Tag Manager, but that's what we're gonna do in the next lesson. For this lesson, please head over to measureschool.com/lesson2 to take the quiz and see how you do in terms of what I explained right here. Then we are ready to tackle the next lesson, which you may already find over here. And yeah, I hope to see you over there, where we're gonna install a new tag inside of Google Tag Manager. Now, my name is Julian. Till next time.